Last year, we took apart the original 125 watts GaN charger of the H30 Ultra. You can click the upper right corner to take a look. And today, we got the H30 Ultra itself, which can support up to 125 watts fast charging. We'll test its charging compatibility to see what kind of third-party chargers can be compatible. The phone we got adopts a wide back cover. The Motorola logo is in the center. It's equipped with Snapdragon 8 Plus processor and a 4,610 mAh battery. It also supports 125 watts wild fast charging and 50 watts wireless fast charging. So you can charge 50% in 7 minutes and 100% in 19 minutes. The charger inside the package is the one we've taken apart. Let's briefly introduce it. It supports input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60Hz, 1.7 amp, and the output can be up to 125 watts. The manufacturer is Ohio Technology. The MOTO logo and the 125 watts power logo are on two sides of the charger, and the USB-C port is orange. There is no current logo on the cable, but it can support at least 6.25 amp. The size of the charger is about 56 by 55 by 29 mm, and the weight is about 154 grams. So the power density is about 1.51 watts cubic centimeter, which is very close to some 65 watts chargers on the market. The ChargerLab Power ZKM002C shows it supports QC 3.0, PD 3.0, PPS, and QC5 protocols. And it also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, 3A, 20 volts, 3.25A, and 2 sets of PPS. Except for the 125 watts, it's also compatible with 65 watts PD protocol. Once you connect it to the original charger, it'll trigger the charging animation, and the real-time power is 104 watts. Even if we replace the cable with an ordinary 5A cable, the power still reaches 85 watts. Next, we're gonna test it with third-party chargers from 20 watts to 100 watts. Start from 20 watts. Most chargers can reach 9 volts, 2A, 18 watts. Then we picked up some 30 watts, 40 watts, and even 50 watts chargers to test it. The most obvious change is that the current has increased to 3A, so the power can reach around 25 watts. Moving to some 65 watt chargers, the situation will be much more complicated. If you're using the pure PD charger, the power will remain at around 25 watts. But if the charger can support PPS protocol, the highest power can even reach 60 watts. That's because some of them can trigger the 17 volts. Other PPS chargers still trigger 9 volts, but the current increases to 4A, so the power can reach 40 watts. The final group is the 100 watts chargers. Like the 65 watts chargers, the pure PD chargers can only support 25 watts, but many third-party chargers can reach more than 80 watts. Compared with the real-time power of 104 watts that the original charger can provide, the overall charging time won't be much longer. Well, I have to say, this is the most compatible device among so many Android phones we've tested. Many third-party chargers can charge the H30 Ultra at an ideal speed, like 80 watts or more, and the performance is comparable to the original 125 watts charger. It also proves that it's not difficult for Android phones to be compatible with third-party chargers, but different manufacturers have different choices. We hope that more and more manufacturers will allow users to choose their favorite third-party chargers. Okay, that's all the tests we made today. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!